This video will explain why some referrals to the Hereditary Cancer Clinic are declined. We will also explain options for you and your family if you are still interested in genetic testing. Your body is made of millions and millions of cells. There are around 20,000 genes inside each cell. Each gene has a special job and tells your body how to grow and how to function. Some genes determine your eye color, your hair color, or how tall you are. Other genes protect your body from developing cancer. If these genes are working properly, they help protect you from cancer. If they are not working properly, you have a higher chance of developing cancer. Cancer is common. More than 40% of Canadians will get cancer in their lifetime. Because cancer is common, it's not unusual to have some family members with cancer. 70 to 80% of cancers happen by chance. These cancers are caused by things like age, lifestyle, and environment, and are called sporadic cancer. About 15 to 20% of cancers have a familial cause. Familial cancers can also be caused by age, lifestyle, environment, and chance, just like sporadic cancers. But small genetic factors may also play a role in developing familial cancer. Unfortunately, we cannot test for the genetic factors that cause familial cancer. Only 5 to 10% of cancers have a hereditary cause. These cancers happen because of a gene that is not working properly and can be passed along in a family. Genetic testing can be used to find out if the cancer in your family has a hereditary cause. In Alberta, genetic testing is covered by Alberta Healthcare if your personal history or personal and family history is suspicious for hereditary cancer. Genetic counselors and doctors look at many factors to help make this decision. These include cancer diagnosed at a young age, rare types of cancer, such as breast cancer in men or ovarian cancer in women, more than one type of cancer in the same person, a pattern of cancer in many generations of the family, belonging to certain ethnic groups, or a family member that has an abnormal positive genetic test result. Genetic testing is not usually available if you do not have a personal history of cancer, unless a hereditary cause has already been identified in a family member. This is because the chance of finding a hereditary cause for cancer is lower if you do not have a personal history of cancer. Also, it can be hard to understand normal test results and what this means for your chance of developing cancer if the family members who had cancer did not have genetic testing. For example, imagine a tree with red apples on it. One day, one of the apples turns green, and you want to know what caused it to change color. You would probably start by inspecting the apple that changed color, not by inspecting the apples that are still red. If you discover something that caused the apple to change color, you can look for the same thing in the other apples to find out if they might turn green too. This is also true with genetic testing. If we want to know what caused cancer in a family member, we must first inspect their genes. If a hereditary cause is found, then other family members can have genetic testing to find out if they're also at high risk of developing cancer. Because of this, it is very important to start genetic testing with a family member who has had cancer. If their test is normal or negative, then we know genetic testing is unlikely to be helpful in your family and you should be screened for cancer based on your family history and other personal risk factors. If their test is abnormal or positive, then genetic testing is helpful for you and your family members and will tell us how likely you are to develop cancer. Unless your family members with cancer have had genetic testing, we cannot fully understand your genetic test results. We encourage you to speak to your family member who has had cancer about why they are the better person to be tested. They can ask their doctor to refer them to their local genetics clinic. If you do not qualify for genetic testing through Alberta Healthcare, you may still want to pay privately to have genetic testing done. Many commercial labs offer hereditary cancer genetic testing that can be ordered by any physician on a private pay basis. It's important to note, not all commercial genetic tests are medically acceptable or relevant. If you would like to learn more about private pay options, we encourage you to speak with your doctor. If you have genetic testing and your results are abnormal positive, you can be referred to your local medical genetics clinic for counseling. It is still important to speak to your doctor about screening recommendations based on your family history of cancer and other personal risk factors. If there are new cancers diagnosed in your family, or if a hereditary cause for cancer is found in your family, please talk to your doctor about whether a new referral should be made to your local medical genetics clinic. We hope this video has helped to explain some information about hereditary cancer and why genetic testing usually starts with a family member who has had cancer.